All right, we are here with Chad Rouse, getting ready to represent for the main event tonight, battling over here in Kalamazoo. Now, Chad, do you know anything about your opponent, man? You got a lot of experience, okay? We and Jackson are not, strangers to this young man who's got a heck of a career started, but a little bit about your game plan and, how you approach your fights, man.
I just fight because I love it, and game plan wise, I just go out there and I strike until they take me down, and I either get up or submit them. I'll beat anybody, anywhere, anytime, and do what I got to do to win. I don't really care about game plans and hype and all that kind of stuff. I'm a dog. I fight, period. You know what I mean? So.
And so, like you said, whether it's stand up or it's on the ground, you feel very confident in your jiu-jitsu skills, and if it goes that way, that's the way you're going to take it. If not, you're fine to stand up and bang with them, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. When I first started, my stand up was the strong point. My grappling was the weak point. You know what I mean? Everybody just knew what to do. But now, with Quincy Rice on my side and all my teammates, Anthony Michael, Corey Horde, Mo Williams, guys who are fighting tonight, these guys really just took my game to another level. So wherever you want to fight me, I'll fight you. So.
Well, excellent, excellent words here from Chad, and best of luck to you tonight, sir, and we look forward to seeing you in the cage, man. Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Hey, we're here with one of the main event fighters of the night, Antoine Gray, getting ready to step in the cage here shortly. How you feeling tonight, sir?
I'm good.
Ready to go?
Yeah, my first time fighting at 170, so I'm feeling good.
Oh, very nice. You usually fight heavier or lighter?
I usually fight at 185 and 205. I'm currently in combat sports league, I'm a world champion. So it's my first time coming down fighting at 170. Weight cut with Chris Gray.
So that's my next question. How are you feeling?
I'm short, man, so it wasn't that bad to get off. It was a little strain, you know. I don't feel like I usually feel, but I'm feeling pretty good.
Now, are you looking to keep this fight on your feet, or are you looking to take it to the ground? What would you prefer?
I'm not saying all that. That's not right now. That is,
a lot of fighters here backstage.
I do a lot of things differently. Every fight, you see different. Keep my opponent guessing. If my opponent see me one fight kicking, please believe you won't see me the next fight kicking. I learn from losses. So if I lose by anything, I'll sharpen up my type, keep going back and do the same thing.
You gotta be rude about
once my weakness is exposed.
You see what I'm doing?
I work on my weaknesses until that's not my weakness anymore.
Well, I think that was very important what you said. You mentioned that you learned from the loss. I don't think that could be said enough. I mean, that's a very, very important part of growing your game.
Yes, and I'm currently on a two-fight losing streak in the upper weight classes. I come down, I'm going to give it everything 100% tonight. I'm not coming out here cocky, guaranteeing no W's, no knockouts, predicting nothing. I just tell you this, I'm on a two-fight losing streak, and then tonight I'm not giving it up easy like my folks have been catching me with. Excuse my language, but a little bit different today here. It's a little bit different. I've been having a couple weeks to do this, you know, I'm a little different right now.
It's all about the focus.
Yeah, it ain't the same pretty flashy girl.
Well, best of luck to you, man.
I appreciate
your weight cut, and you know how hard that is, man. Best of luck to you, man. Have a good time in the cage tonight.
Thank you.
Who are you fighting?
Fighting out of a blue corner, he weighed in at 169 pounds.
I do it for the Lord. I'm not a perfect guy, but I'm a perfect guy. want to say thank you to my team. I want to say thank you to Goose Man, Q, everybody who came out, man. Joe Sharp, my dad, everybody, man. I feel great. You can ask me any questions. I'm talking a lot.
No, man, you mentioned Antoine. I mean, you talk about a game opponent. And you were also talking about your ground game. You were in the guard. You were dealing with some pretty good ground and pound, man. But your defense was fantastic. You looked very comfortable down there. You were able to produce some excellent movement and avoid a lot of those strikes. So you can't say enough about your ground game. But then to turn it around and lock in that excellent leg triangle must feel fantastic.
Hey, I'm not just a striker anymore. I don't just strike, I can do it all now, baby. That's because of you, the ex-MMA, everybody, man. They made me a complete mixed martial artist.
Well, it looked like there was a slight opportunity in the first round to possibly look for that triangle, but you were timing it out right, taking your, you know, working your right moments, and really taking the chance when you had it. And you locked it in, pulled that head down, got the blood flow, and it looked like lights were out.
And I wanted to broke it up a little bit on the ground, you know what I mean? Get him tired, get him brushed so I can wear him out a little bit. Get tired, they make mistakes. He got tired, he made a mistake. Great fighter, just made one mistake, it could change everything. So I wanted to get him tired, and he got tired.
Fantastic finish. What a great way to end the night, Chad. Congratulations. We look forward to seeing you again, sir. Great fight.
Hey, thank you so much, man. Shout out to my mom. I love you very much. Have a good night, everybody. Drive safe.
He fights for Jackson Mixed Martial Arts. Woo. He is the baptized by blood 170-pound champion and former